Every year, the experts at U.S. News & World Report rank the nation's best hospitals. They've recognized St. Vincent as the number one hospital in Arkansas and listed 8 clinical areas as high-performing specialties. The next closest Arkansas hospital only had 3. This recognition is due to the unwavering commitment of our world-class physicians, dedicated nurses, and associates who have now made St. Vincent the state's number one hospital.
Are you feeling tired because and also have sudden weight loss? There are many signs that your thyroid may be experiencing problems. In observance of Thyroid Awareness Month here in January, we have Dr. Morgan Sauer at the Longevity Center at St. Vincent. Great to see you.
Good morning to you.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year as well.
Well, first of all, I always hear about the thyroid gland. Yeah. Where is it and what is it?
Thyroid is pretty much going to be under the knot of a tie on a man's neck.
So right,
same place
here.
On the woman. There's a little top of the breastbone. If you put your finger just slightly under that, that's where the thyroid's normally going to be. Now, okay. If it gets too big because something's wrong, it'll kind of rise up, and that's when doctors can put their hands around the neck and actually feel it and feel that something's abnormal.
All right. And so what does it do? What's its function in our body?
The thyroid is kind of cool. It's like the thermostat of the body. It tells you if you're going to run faster or if you're going to run slower. So when things go wrong with the thyroid, there's unique symptoms that go with being too cold and too hot. It's kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears.
That's a good way to put it.
Simple.
All right. So there's 2 types of problems with the thyroid.
In general, the most common is going to be hypothyroidism, and women have a higher propensity for this than men, but you can't forget that men can get this too. Low thyroid is going to cause you to have kind of excessive weight gain. You're just going to feel run down, draggy, like the engine's not firing as much as it should. So you're going to have fatigue, weight gain, depression. Sometimes people can have sleep disturbances, abnormal menstrual periods in women, dry skin, hair falling out. There's all sorts of symptoms of just not running at full speed.
And this is treatable?
Fortunately, it's very treatable. Generic medications, $4 a month, can take care of this and bring people feeling back to normal. It's wonderful when I find something like this and people just feel terrible and their quality of life is horrible. We put them on a nice, cheap medication. They come back, "Doc, I feel so much better." You don't have to feel bad.
So you say it occurs more in women than men. Mm-hmm. How so? I mean, was it by a large percentage?
Probably about 15-20% more common in women than men, maybe even more than that.
Okay.
It's interesting, sometimes in psychiatric hospitals that I've worked in, we see people who have psychiatric disturbances from having a low thyroid.
Really?
We get them replaced, and they're doing much, much better.
So it's an easy fix. Can it be life-threatening?
It can be life-threatening. I've only seen very few cases of life-threatening, but yes, it can be. Usually these people look extremely abnormal. They have very gravelly voices, and they start to lose their hair in huge clumps. So usually they're seen by a doctor before that happens.
All right, and so there's an opposite to this, the thyroid problem. Hyperthyroidism?
Hyperthyroidism. And some people think that being hyperthyroidism is going to help them. It really doesn't. Hyperthyroid can cause weight loss, especially rapid weight loss. You may feel warmer when most people feel cooler. You can have decreased appetite or increased appetite. This can cause a lot of anxiety because you're running too fast. Additionally, you can absolutely get cardiac abnormalities, so you can have faster heartbeats or even go into atrial fibrillation that can subsequently cause a stroke. So finding a hyperthyroid is very important because there are ways to treat that.
Is this treatable?
Absolutely. First thing you can do is you can use thyroid blocking medications and using generic blood pressure medications to help block the symptoms. If the thyroid's not going to cool itself down over some time, like say from a viral infection, then you can absolutely give some iodine and cause the thyroid to shrink. Some people have to have part of the thyroid taken out, which is now a day surgery. You can go in, get part of the thyroid out, and go home the same day.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Now, can you live without your thyroid?
Certainly you can these days. We have medications that can replace the function of the thyroid and do a great job with it.
All right. So if you have any questions for Dr. Sauer, he's there, a lot of great doctors at the Longevity Center at St. Vincent. If you think you might be suffering from one of these symptoms that we've listed here, you want to get checked out, they're located at 1 St. Vincent Circle here in Little Rock. The phone number for more information is 501-552-4777. I've learned a lot about thyroids that I never really knew.
Most people don't.
Yeah.
It's good to see you too.
Great to see you.
Happy New Year.
Yeah.